गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर इन बायो क्लास 8 लेसन 6 दैट इज हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन। यू ऑल नो व्हाट इज हेल्थ एंड व्हाट इज डिजीज। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू डिस्क्राइब और डिफाइन व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ हेल्थ। हेल्थ इज अ स्टेट ऑफ कंप्लीट फिजिकल मेंटल एंड सोशल वेलबींग ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल। So whenever our body is fit, physically, mentally as well as socially means we are in a healthy state. And there are some factors for the good health, that is a healthy diet. First of all, our diet should be healthy, then our body is healthy, means we are in a good health. Second is physical exercise. Daily we should do physical exercise. Physical exercise means the exercise which we can do like sports, games, walking, running. These are all the types of the physical exercise, swimming, dancing. And the third most important factor is the adequate rest. So rest is very essential for our body. So these are the three factors which lead to good health, that is the healthy diet, balanced diet, physical exercise and adequate rest. Now whenever our body remains unhealthy means we are one way or the other we are suffering from disease. So what is actually the disease? Disease is made from two words. This is means whenever it is a particular state in which the organism or the organ or the system of the body fails to function normally, means whenever any organ or system of our body fails means they does not work properly. Every organ or every system of our body has particular function, and whenever any organ or the system does not work properly, they fails to function properly, then we suffer from one or the other kind of the disease. And the disease is transmitted through various factors or various agents, we can say. What are these agents for the transmission of disease? The different agents are, the first is the germs. What are the germs? They are the microorganisms which cause disease like virus, bacteria, fungi, protozoa. So these are the germs, or we can say it is also the pathogens which enter in one way or the other inside our body and they cause disease. Second cause of the disease is the parasitic worms. Parasitic worms means parasitic is derived from the word parasite. Parasite means which live in the host body, like tapeworm. Tapeworm live in the intestine of the animals and from there it enters to the human beings and cause different disease. So these are the parasitic worms. So some parasitic worms also cause disease in our body, in the body of the organism or some animals. And the third agent is the vectors through which the disease, means which are the carrier of the disease. Like you have heard about the malaria. Malaria is caused or it carries by the mosquito, that is female Anopheles, which carries the germs of the malaria, that is Plasmodium. And whenever that mosquito bites the healthy person which is carrying the Plasmodium germs, so that Plasmodium is transferred to the body of the healthy person and he suffers from malaria. So that is means here the female Anopheles, they act as a vector. So these three are the mainly the transmission of the disease. We can say they are the agent through which the disease transmits, by germs, virus, bacteria, fungi, protozoans, by the parasites, that is parasitic worms like tapeworm, and third is the through vectors. Now I want to tell you that these infectious agent or the organism which cause disease, these are only called the pathogens. And I want to discuss some name of some disease. There are so many disease which are caused in person, and a person feels disease or He feels unhealthy only whenever we see the symptoms in his body, either external symptoms or any kind of signs if we see in the body of that person or the animal, means he is suffering from disease. And here I want to discuss some disease, their pathogens as well as the symptoms. So first disease mainly is the cholera. Cholera you all know, have heard about, and its pathogen is the which cause disease is the Vibrio cholerae. It is a germ. And what happens in malaria is what are the symptoms we see in the body of the person? That frequent diarrhea as well as vomiting. So that is the main symptoms of the cholera, and this type of disease can be prevented by maintaining personal hygiene like washing hands and drinking clean water, boiled water, as well as eating the covered food and avoid eating uncovered food. So these are proper sanitation facilities should be there. So these are the some of the preventive measures, methods by which we can prevent such kind of disease. Second is the typhoid. You might have heard about typhoid. It is caused by Salmonella typhi. It is the name of the pathogen. And in typhoid, what happens? The person suffers from fever, headache, and rashes in the body. And here also we can do the same thing, means personal hygiene or proper sanitation facilities, drinking clean water, boiled water, eating covered food. These are also some of the preventive measures by which we can prevent this disease. Another is the influenza. Influenza is mostly caused by influenza virus, and here also we see that the body suffers from fever or body ache there is. So such kind of disease can be prevented by avoiding close contact with the person who is suffering from that particular disease. And another is the poliomyelitis. Poliomyelitis is also a type of disease which is caused by polio virus, and here especially there is a paralysis of the limbs, the symptoms which we see, and this disease can be prevented by vaccination. So small children, especially at the age of 1 to 5 years, they are vaccinated by this poliomyelitis virus to prevent from polio. Another type of disease is the chicken pox, which is caused by varicella virus. And here also we can see the symptom in the body of the person, rashes and poke marks in the abdomen and in the whole body, especially in the limbs and hands. And this disease can also be prevented by vaccination. And malaria, I have already told you, malaria is caused by female Anopheles mosquito, and it is the germs which the female Anopheles mosquito carries, the Plasmodium. And if a person is suffering from malaria, means there is a severe fever with chills in his body. So this type of disease can be prevented by preventing the breeding of mosquito. And the breeding of mosquito can be prevented by maintaining the community hygiene, by using mosquito nets, as well as cleanliness in our surroundings. So these are some name of the some disease, their causative agents, as well as the symptoms what the person shows in his body if he or she suffers from such kind of disease, and what type of preventive measures he can adopt so that to prevent from such kind of communicable disease. So in the next class I will deal with some more disease and more topics regarding this class. Thank you.